In this video, we are going to talk about top 10 most dramatic moments of the 2021. So before starting, please like this video and subscribe to this channel for our future updates. Despite the fact that the outside world continues to be a long trudge to who knows where, I've managed to find delight in football throughout the whole year. While facing some different hurdles in each league, players did their best to entertain, excite and provide anybody watching with the joy of witnessing magic happen on the field or court. Here are the top 10 most dramatic moments of the 2021. So let's start. Number 10. Trinity Rodman defies expectations. The Washington Spirit drafted the 2021 NWSL Rookie of the Year with great expectations. Many tempered expectations due to her age, youth, but Trinity Rodman never doubted her ability. Her performance at the NWSL Championship encapsulates her character. After repeatedly being frustrated by her own and the Chicago Red Stars defenders, something clicked inside Rodman in the second half, and she began to take control of the game. That led to her producing the equalizer pass and, more importantly, the inch-perfect cross that led to the Spirit's game winner. Number 9. Ada Hegerberg returning from her injury. I spoke with Ada Hegerberg right before she made her long-awaited return to the football field. She was as enthusiastic and well-prepared as someone could possibly be, and when the moment arrived, the world welcomed her with open arms as she had hoped. She then scored her first goal since returning from injury, against Paris Saint-Germain, as Olympique Lyonnais attempted to recapture the French League Championship. Number 8. Casey Murphy versus Australia. It's always worth noting when an outstanding goaltending performance, such as Casey Murphy's against Australia, is placed on display. Goalkeepers aren't given nearly as much credit as other positions on the field, and even if they play excellently, if the rest of the team fails to do so, they'll still concede a large number of goals and be overlooked despite their outstanding efforts. This time, a goalkeeper played so admirably that, even when the rest of the team crumbled, he or she was still able to seal the victory for his or her team. Number 7. Fridolina Rolfo goal versus Arsenal. If you didn't know, Fridolina Rolfo scores for pleasure. She displayed it during the Olympics against Australia and again against Arsenal FC in the UWCL a few weeks ago. Rolfo, a left back for Barcelona, gets forward a lot due to the Spanish champion's style of play. Against Arsenal, Rolfo picked up the ball outside the box and bent it in off the post, away from the goalkeeper's despairing dive. Number 6. The USWNT's disallowed goal against Mexico. Remember the USWNT's sweeping move that culminated in an offside goal by Chrisson Press just before the Olympics? That goal has stayed with me. It had everything you could ask for in a tactical and aesthetic sense. That type of mobility was absent at the Tokyo Olympics in 2021, but whenever I have a chance, I retrace the team's steps and wonder where they went. The USWNT can do that, and as someone who appreciates seeing excellent movement joined together to create something exceptional, I hope it becomes more common in the future. Number 5. PSG win the Division 1 feminine title. After 21 years of watching others win the title, barely pipping them and witnessing Olympique Lyonnais win 14 in a row, PSG finally stopped Lyon's juggernaut and won the Division 1 feminine for the first time. For as far as I can remember, the French title has been decided by who wins the head-to-head matches, and in a year in which Paris Saint-Germain defeated Lyon in the Champions League, they did enough in the league to deny their fiercest rivals a 15th consecutive crown. Number 4. Barcelona decimating Chelsea. When FC Barcelona advanced to the UEFA Women's Champions League final a few months ago, the bulk of the English-language press did not believe it was possible. In the weeks leading up to the final, most observers predicted that PSG would knock them out in the semi-finals, and that if this didn't happen, Chelsea FC would be too formidable to beat them in the final. When the final whistle blew in May, it became clear that this had been a poor wager. Number 3. Eugenie Lassomer's goal versus Racing Louisville. Eugenie Lassomer's time in the NWSL was brief, but she left an indelible mark on all of us throughout her time in the United States. As OL Reign FC attempted to climb the ladder and qualify for the playoffs, Lasomer scored a goal that we will remember for a long time. Everything about this goal was fantastic, from the rapid movement of her feet to the ability to finish elegantly with a curling effort. In my opinion, leaving your defender on the ground also serves to emphasize how good your goal is. Number 2. Barbara Banda, no further explanation needed. As someone who lives on the border of Zambia, seeing them, particularly Barbara Banda, make their mark on the world stage was tremendously gratifying. Zambia, like my own country, is a little country that is rarely recognized when it comes to Africa's great footballing nations, but the Zambian team did everything they could to ensure that you remember them this summer. Barbara Banda was the driving force behind Zambia's Olympic success, scoring 2 hat tricks against the Netherlands and China as the country attempted to qualify for the knockout stages. Despite the fact that their scoreline suggested otherwise, watching Banda make finishing look so effortless was worth having the Zambians at the Olympics. Throughout Zambia's campaign, Banda shown excellent awareness and skill in front of goal, and if anyone deserved more respect for her name than Barbara Banda, it was her. Number 1. Canada wins a historic gold medal. It's always the bridesmaid, never the other way around. For years, that was the phrase that could be applied to Canada's efforts to win an international title, as they fell short of the United States women's national team. Amid challenging circumstances in Tokyo, the Canadians accomplished something they had come so close to accomplishing 9 years earlier in London, defeating the United States and winning a gold medal at the Olympics. Against the USWNT in the semifinal, it took a penalty kick from Jesse Fleming for Canada to overcome their mental block, and it required an outstanding defensive effort from their back five to defeat Sweden in penalties and earn gold for the first time in the history of the program. What do you think of our video? Let me know in the comment section below. If you enjoy this video and want to hear from me again, be sure to hit that subscribe button before you go. Thanks for watching.